Hi, I'm Brandon. I'm the CEO and owner here at CrossFit South Bend. Today, we're going to discuss the difference between training for health and longevity, training for performance for a competition, or training for both at the same time. First, let's all get on the same page. I'll put out some definitions. Your definition might be a little different from mine, and that's okay. These definitions are how we're going to base the topic of discussion for the day. First, what is health? Health is the condition of being sound in body, mind, or spirit, especially freedom from physical disease or pain. And what is a competitor? A competitor is someone who's trying to win or do better than all others, especially in business or sports, someone who is competing. Our answers here at CrossFit South Bend is very often, it depends. We have to set some context for the conversations we have. With that being said, our answer also depends on what you are competing in. How aggressive your training at higher levels of competition really depends on what the sport or the endeavor is. Are you a competitive bowler, rugby player, MMA fighter, CrossFit Games competitor? Each sport has its own demands that require a certain level of responsibility and possible imbalances from the individual at high levels of that sport. Also, we need to know more about that individual. What is their athletic history, their training age, their genetics, resilience to stressors, lifestyle and consistency with that lifestyle? There are many other factors to take into account, but this is to say that there are plenty of things to consider when getting to a more accurate and individualized answer. We get these questions a lot, so let's use a CrossFit athlete as an example. The amount of lifestyle focus it takes to bring an already pretty good CrossFit athlete up to realizing their full potential usually will take a pretty significant lifestyle change. We're talking a lot of training volume, intensity, and focus. If I had a young athlete who came to me and asked to get as good as they can to reach genetic potential in the sport of CrossFit in 7 years, that means they'll be progressing a combination of volume, intensity, to new heights intelligently over the course of those 7 years. For that individual, it might possibly mean creating the level of training that, starting at 18, when they're 25, a day could include 4 hours of aerobic training, 3 hours of strength, skill, and other energy system training, 3.5 hours of eating, an hour and a half of recovery, and 11 hours of sleep. This is a pretty aggressive response, but it's not far off if your goal in the sport is realizing your athletic potential. Once that discussion has been had, there aren't many people who are interested in creating a situation that resembles that in their life, or really can for that matter, by comparison to the people who say that they want it. Getting to the highest level of individual performance relative to your potential means you'll have to progressively increase training volume and intensity over time, which means you'll have to compromise your health even when focusing on the highest levels of lifestyle and nutrition practices. At that point, depending on the sport, the individual may be so far from their body's natural state of being in terms of balance that they might be on the verge of chronic disease, uncontrollable and undesired cell growth, or both. This lack of balance in the body may not be realized immediately, but it's the direction the athlete will have to take to sustain that work over time, which is what's required to realize performance potential. Now, let's take somebody from a sedentary state. Increases in performance and lifestyle focus from where they sit can mean huge improvements for them. What could this look like? Mostly bodybuilding work, easy aerobic work, workouts with little to no metabolic disruption like lactate work, workouts with little to no dynamic contractions, workouts with little CNS taxing. Now, before people get their pitchforks out, you can still be healthy and have strength speed movements, dynamic contractions, CNS taxing, occasional metabolic disruption. The example above is simply a prescription that would give a reasonable base of support to live long and prosper. This does not mean you're going to go out and crush performance markers frequently, and that there are not other methods of training to live long and prosper. This is just a very reasonable way to stay strong and use your training in day-to-day function. In order to meet in the middle and get to the highest levels of health means an individual will probably be at some moderate level of sports performance, depending on that sport. This intersection of health and focus and lifestyle will occur at an above average level of performance relative to the individual's innate athletic potential. Now, there's no shame in admitting that you don't want to achieve your true genetic potential in performance at the expense of all health considerations. There's no shame in admitting that you don't want to have the highest level of lifestyle focus that's required to get there either. Additionally, there's no shame in admitting that you don't care to be as healthy as possible because you enjoy increasing your performance further. The best thing that one can do is be aware of the realities of these relationships between health, performance, and lifestyle, and decide where one would like to be based on one's values, then take the actions that align with those decisions and values.